One of the biggest issues that I see when people are implementing ClickUp and trying to get their team on board is not being able to easily show their team what needs to get done. Their team easily is getting lost in all the things you just implemented, automated, and imported into ClickUp, and they have no idea what they actually need to do or how to find their task. And today I'm going to give you 5 easy ways how you can make your team's life easier and therefore your own. Hi everybody, I'm Yvonne Heimann with AskEvie.com and I am a business efficiency consultant for digital entrepreneurs. And if you are ready to make your team's life easy and therefore yours, hit the subscribe button and join the conversation right here on my YouTube channel. Now let's talk about team management. Team management is not just telling people what to do, but you as a manager, you as the CEO, whatever size your team is, however many people you have to manage, your job is it to make it easy for your team to know what to do when and how. We're not gonna talk about the how, but we're gonna talk about what they need to do and when. My tip number one, custom list view by department, speaks a lot specifically to agency setups. But even if you're not an agency, this kind of custom list view will easily allow you to build custom list views based on person, based on focus, whatever you want to do. You literally just need to filter the list by it. Let's head on over to my ClickUp so I can show you what it means to build a custom list view within ClickUp, where we apply that, and how it makes your team's life easier. Now, as you have seen in some of my past videos, how we implement the ClickUp hierarchy for agencies is our clients are on the folder level and we have lists underneath for the client training, for the client hub, which is where all the client tasks go into and the client onboarding, client assets, the whole branding, logo, colors, and all of that. And then we have lists underneath for the services rendered, the stuff they hired us for. And it's duplicated. We do the same thing for the next client and the next client and the next client. All the spaces look the same. Now, where have agencies struggled with this is like, yeah, but my web design department doesn't care what graphic design is doing. Yeah, they actually do because they designed the graphics for the website, but that's a whole nother story. Web design only wants to see web design. So let's say department that is rendering services A wants to see everything they need to do and that's happening in their department. Which is quite simple, actually. And all of these setups are based on your team being full members. There are some limitations if your team is coming in as a guest member. I will not be covering that. I talked about that in another video. Going in the everything view, things in here are often quite chaotic. Everything is in here. By standard, it's grouped by status. Brace yourself, we're not gonna keep it like that. In this case, if we are building a custom list based on services A, we are going in here and we are setting up a filter based on location. And location is our client space. And then we go through our clients and choose services A. Now we go into client B and we are again choosing services A. To get you a couple of tasks in here and not have it empty, it is my sandbox. Let's choose the template folder too. I usually keep a template folder for easy duplication right in here. Just duplicate new client, cool. Save it as a template too. But I usually do not put those into these custom list views. And as you can see, I didn't have a task in services A. Do I have a task in services B? Huh. And apparently I don't have any test tasks even in the client template folder. Fine, we'll add some in a second. Make sure to save it. We'll just change this to autosave. And now we have a department list. Let's add a couple of tasks just so you actually know how this will look like. Let's move these tasks right into the client services A. And now going back into our filtered list view, you can see that client A, services A, those two tasks that we just moved show up in here. Now to make this a nice clean department list, what we usually do in here, we sort this by due date, meaning going up and going down, you always want the oldest on top, to not worry about the whole truncation that happens per folder. What we also gonna do is go into this menu and show task location. With these changes in this custom list view, first of all, you are going to see all the tasks for services A, so for the department you are setting this up for. You are seeing which client those tasks are related to by this one up here. You see it right there, client A, services A. That's where those tasks are coming from. You see your assignee and due date right on top. Now suddenly you have a perfect custom list based on your department, and your departments don't have to worry about all the other stuff that's going on. They can just focus on what they need to get done. Now, little pro tip, you can do this on space level 2. I like to do it all the way up on everything because that's where most of our customization is happening. But you can do these same kind of custom views in the space level as well as in the folder level. So you need to figure out for yourself how you would like to handle this, or if you're gonna have guest access for this, which is not available in everything. Easy way number 2 for your team to know exactly what they need to pay attention to is actually a really simple solution. Folder colors. Folder colors allow you to say, hey, this is a high-paying VIP client. We need to pay attention to them. This is red. Or there is a big, big, big event happening and we really need to pay attention to this client. There it is red. This is a go. Client is done with onboarding. Let's get the work done. Make the folder green. However you would like to sort this, color it, customize it, make it work for you, come up with a system and make use of these folder colors to easily tell your team which client they need to pay attention to. Which leads us straight into tip number 3 to make your team's life easier in ClickUp. Have some fun with it. Use emojis. For some of my agencies that are having account managers, what we have implemented is something really simple, and you can implement this anywhere and everywhere. Little pro tip right here, use JoyPixel, which is a Chrome extension, to easily grab any kind of emojis. And then what we do is we use a specific emoji for each account manager. And for the account manager to easily know which of these folders slash clients are they supposed to take care of, we use the emojis. And now with these emojis right next to the client name in the folder, your account manager easily knows which of those folders slash clients they need to take care of in ClickUp. Now for tip number 4 to make your team's life easier in ClickUp, I'm actually gonna take you into my system. So let's leave the sandbox behind and let's go into my own system right here in ClickUp. This is a support ticketing system. For your team to easily be able to get client feedback, know what is not working, especially with things like web design or events happening for social media posts, anything where the client is like, oh my God, oh my God, oh my God, this has to happen now. A client support ticketing setup right here in ClickUp is the perfect solution. Now I will be talking about how to set this up and what best way to structure this within ClickUp and all those things in another upcoming video. So if you haven't subscribed yet, go for it, because this is coming up on how to build a support ticketing system in ClickUp as well as how to automate it. But for you to see, the idea behind it is really simple. You use a ClickUp form to build a support ticket form, which then turns into a task right in ClickUp. You're gonna need to figure out if you want to have that specifically for clients in a folder, or if you want to have a list specific just for support tickets that then get moved to the specific client. Again, this is too much to crank into this video. You will get a separate video about that, so make sure you are subscribed so you get notified when I release that video. Last but not least, let's head on back over to my sandbox. I talked about this before. 2 really, really, really simple tricks to make your team's life easier. Meme out. The moment you hit meme out, it's all about you. Tasks that are getting built are automatically assigned to you. You are only seeing your task. You know exactly what's happening, what you need to take care of, and everything else that's happening around you is just gone. It's like focus mode in ClickUp. The second one of this one is your on fire list. This is team-wide. Having an on fire list is a custom list on the everything view that pulls on all of the tasks, and it is grouped by priority, meaning the red flags are all the way on top, which means you need to use the priority feature in ClickUp and use your flags for really burning things so that they pop up on top, and then sort it by due date. This will allow your team, once they're in Memo, to see exactly what is high priority for them, what is past due, what's happening, and you as the manager or the CEO can get out of the me mode and see what's happening in the company, what is high priority, not done throughout the whole company, not just for yourself, and past due. And as you can see, there's a lot of templates in here, so there's a lot of past due. And with these five tips to make your team's life easier right here in ClickUp, I invite you to go check out this video I have recorded in the past for you on how to get your team on board with ClickUp, and even more tips on making it easier for your team to find their way around and really get them excited about ClickUp. And don't forget to subscribe if you haven't done so yet, because I want to see you again in my next video.